friends. Welcome to Nurturing Faith. Today, I'm standing here with my friend, Pastor Maura, and we're here on our church campus in front of our Plymouth Preschool. Now, some of my friends out there, you might have attended our Plymouth Preschool, and this area will look familiar to you, our outdoor play area. And I'm so happy that you're here to join us today. Today, our lesson comes from the Gospel according to John, chapter 15, verses 9 to 17. I'm going to say that again because I want you to be sure to look that up in your Bible books and read it with your mom and dad, grandma, grandpa, your big brother, big sister, an adult that you would just like to spend some time with. Read John chapter 15, verses 9 through 17. And in this story, Jesus is talking about what it means to be a good friend. And he's also explaining to the disciples why he's calling them friends. And so when I was thinking about that, I thought about my friends that I met here in this community, this place that we call Plymouth Congregational Church. And I thought, man, I have Pastor Maura.
Yep, you got me.
I have Cindy, I have Melanie, I have Bonnie, I have Lee, I have Julie. And I know you can get in trouble when you start naming your friends and maybe you forgot someone and left them out. But friends know that I love you. And so I want you to think about your friends that you may have at school, and then think about the friends that you have here at church. And it's within community, community meaning a group of people together, that we find these friendships. And we share so many things with
That's
each
right.
other that when you're not feeling too good, I remember I had to have a test at a hospital, and Pastor Maura, I didn't even know it. She surprised me, and she came and she met me, and she sat there and held my hand and said, "You don't have to worry. Everything's going to be all right." That's what friends do for you. And I know you have friends like that, probably a friend that you can share lunch with or share your favorite crayons with, or just a friend that you can play a game with, or just walk with. And so that's the thing that I want you to take away from this lesson today. Jesus was calling his disciples and those that followed him especially was friends. And the friends for Jesus was, well, the friends, they were his family, and they are his family. So your friends can become your family, because my blood family doesn't live close by to me here, but I have my church family that means just as much for me, to me, and who look out for me the same way my blood family does. So, Pastor Maura, what do you think about friendship in this place?
Well, you know, I think, Andrea, so many times, I think about this beautiful big oak tree. Because so many times underneath this oak tree, sometimes people meet here for the first time. They don't know everybody. They don't know everybody at church. So they come here and they are walking to church or maybe walking to Davis Hall or here for Inspirited. And underneath the shade of this tree, we are important that we introduce ourselves to one another. Because if you don't know somebody, you just don't know that that might be the person that God put there that day to become your new friend. So when we come to church, we try real hard to introduce ourselves and to be friendly.
Yes.
And welcoming so that we can make all kinds of new friends and introduce them to our old friends. I watched that happening when we were here for Inspirited.
Yes.
There were new people who'd never come before. And there were kids who'd been coming here since they were little. And everybody was singing together and worshiping together and having fun together and becoming friends.
Friends.
Becoming good friends. So I always think about this tree as being just a beautiful place where we can all become friends when we come here to church.
That is so beautiful. That just warms my heart. So friends, when you think about those places that you're able to make friends, and just like Jesus was teaching all the lessons about how much God wants us to first and foremost love God, and then to love each other. That is what Jesus was teaching. That is the most important thing that I want you to take away from today's Nurturing Faith. To love God and to love each other.
Love you, Andrea.
I love you too, Pastor Maura, or Maura, because we are friends. And let the church, us too, say, Amen.